In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make a flying text effect inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So I've got this video with this low zoom in of the globe, and to do this, we're gonna come to Effects, Titles, and we're gonna drag and drop a text plus into the timeline, like this. Now we're gonna come to second 2, which is where I want the effect to start, and we're gonna place the text right at this point. And remember, I'm doing a simple version of this effect, but you can tweak it and adjust it as much as you want to make it look even nicer. So let's do this. Making sure the text is selected, I'm gonna come to title, and then I thought about adding some country names to it. Well, let's start with the United States. Now we're gonna come to shading, select element number 2, red outline, and enable it. Now we're gonna come to this red color right here and change it to black, just to give it a bit of an outline. Now we're gonna make the text fall from above. So we're gonna come at second 2, select the text, and set a keyframe here at center X and Y. Now we're gonna go 15 frames ahead and set another keyframe. And keep in mind that depending on your timeline's frame rate, your numbers are gonna be different than mine. I'm at 30 frames per second, so 15 frames represent half a second. Okay, now we're gonna go back to second 2 and slide the Y axis to the right until it gets out of the screen. Like this. Now let's see how it goes. Cool, but to make it look smoother, we're gonna click on this button right here, and this is gonna head us over to Fusion. So here in Fusion, we're gonna click on Spline, and this is where we can see all of our curve movements. Now we're gonna select Displacement, and we're gonna click on this button right here, Zoom to Fit. We're gonna select this keyframe right here, and we're gonna hit F on the keyboard. Now we're gonna hold Option or Alt on the keyboard, click on this bezier right here, and pull it a little bit to the left. Like, this is fine. Now let's go back to the edit page. Let's see how it looks now. A lot smoother, right? Now we're gonna give it some depth movement, and we're gonna do that by coming to second 3, clicking on the text, and now we're gonna set a keyframe right here on center Z, like this. Now, going straight to second 6, we're gonna slide this to the left just a little bit, like this is fine. Now let's make it disappear as it gets closer to us. So we're gonna go back to second 3, which is where the movement starts. We're gonna come to settings, and down here at composite, we're gonna set a keyframe in the opacity. Now, going back to second 6, we're gonna slide the opacity all the way to 0, like this. Let's see how it goes. Cool. Now that we have our main texts all set up and ready, we're gonna make some copies of it. And you can do that by hitting Option or Alt on the keyboard, left clicking the text, and dragging it one layer above, like this. Let's make a few more copies. Now let's reposition them, and we can do that by hitting on this arrow right here and selecting the transform button. Now we can click on the second text and just move it around, like this. Let's do the same with the other ones. And let's give them some country names. Okay, now I'm gonna disable the transform button, and let's see how they look. Okay, but it still looks a bit flat, right? So let's make them fall in different times. To do that, we're gonna select from text 2 up to text 5, and we're gonna move them 5 frames to the right. Let's do it again with the last 3 texts, 5 frames more. Now with the last 2, 5 frames more. And with the last one, 5 frames more. And to make this fall look realistic, we gotta add some motion blur to it. And to do that, we're gonna select the text, now come to title, settings, and select motion blur. And let's increase the quality to, let's say, 8. Now let's do the same with the other ones. And let's see how they look now. Okay, now let's go to a frame where we can see all the texts, and we're gonna give them some depth to make them look far away from each other. And we're gonna do that with each text individually. So we're gonna select the last text, and we're gonna come to Fusion. And here, we're gonna select this box, hit Shift Spacebar on the keyboard, and select Gaussian Blur. Let's add it. Make sure it's connected by dragging it around, like this. And if it's not connected, you can simply place it on this line right here, select Shift, and when this line turns blue, you can drop it. Now let's mess with the strength of the blur right here. This is fine. Let's go back to the edit page. Now we're gonna disable this text, and we can do that by hitting D on the keyboard, select our bottom text, go back to Fusion, and do the same. Now with the next one. And with this one. Now let's re-enable them, and we can also do that by hitting D on the keyboard. Now, one final touch. To increase the depth, let's mess around with the scale. But before that, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any more videos that I post here every week. So to do that, we're gonna select the text, come to settings, and mess around with the zoom. So let's make this one smaller, this one a bit smaller too, this one a bit larger, and this one a little smaller. Now, let's see how the final effect looks. And if you want to learn another cool text effect inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on our screen right now, and I'll see you there.